Good morning, my dear students. Today we will discuss lesson 11, the finishing point, and page number is 113. Let's read. Razia has been awarded a prize in the annual sports of her school. The prize is a book on Indian athletes. So Razia, a little girl, got a prize in the annual sports of her school, and it was a book, and the book was about Indian athletes. Athlete means a person who is trained or skilled in sports. This book contains a chapter on the life of PT Usha, the sprint queen of India. So in that book there was a chapter on the life of PT Usha, and PT Usha is known as the sprint queen of India. Sprint means a short running race at a very fast speed. As Razia is very eager to know about PT Usha, she started reading the book right away after dinner. So Razia was very curious and enthusiastic to know about PT Usha. So she didn't waste any time. She started reading immediately after dinner. So right away means without any delay or immediately. Pilavula Kandi Thikke Perambil Usha, generally known as PT Usha, is indeed the most famous and successful female athlete from India. So PT Usha's full name is Pilavula Kandi Thikke Perambil Usha. She is one of the most iconic women athletes of India. Her extraordinary performance at the track earned Usha titles like the Queen of Indian Running Track and Paili Express. So PT Usha earned various titles like Paili Express and the Queen of Indian Running Track for her incredible performances. We also know her as the Queen of Indian Track and Field. PT Usha was born on 27th June 1964 at Paioli, a village in the Paioli district of Kerala. So Paioli is a district in Kerala where she was born. Though Usha was affected by ill health in her early childhood, her promise in sports could be clearly noticed. So in her childhood, PT Usha was not physically fit. She was poverty stricken. She didn't belong to a rich family and rich and wealthy family. She was poor and she was not physically fit. But we could see that she had a strong commitment for sports. Against all odds, she succeeded in becoming one of the greatest athletes India has ever produced. She achieved success against many obstacles in life. She became one of the greatest athletes in India. Though she was not physically fit, but she achieved success through hard work, determination, and strong willpower. She made her first national record in the 100 meters sprint in 1977 when she was just 13 years old. So when she was teenager, at that time she earned her first national record in the 100 meters sprint in 1977. Let's continue. PT Usha could not perform to her ability in the 1980 Moscow Olympics. Even in the 1982 New Delhi Asiad, she could only win silver medals in the 100 meters and 200 meters sprint. So in Moscow Olympics and New Delhi Asiad, she could not perform at her best. So then she worked more harder. However, at the Asian Track and Field ATF Championship in Kuwait a year later, Usha won the gold medal in the 400 meters race with a new Asian record. So, with hard work, after 1 year, she won the gold medal in the 400 meters race, which was held in Kuwait. Thereafter, Usha picked up 13 gold medals at the ATF meets that were held between 1983 to 1989. So, next, she bagged 13 gold medals at the ATF meets between 1983 to 1989. She finished first in the semifinals in the 1984 Los Angeles Olympics but faltered in the finals. So in 1984 Los Angeles Olympics, she became first in the semifinals, but unfortunately in the final round, she could not win. History repeated itself when, in a nail-biting photo finish, by 1/100th of a second, Usha lost the bronze medal. So, PT Usha lost the bronze medal by the difference of a millimicrosecond. And nail-biting means very exciting match, and photo finish means very close finish. The same incident had happened to another great Indian athlete, Milkha Singh, in the 1960 Olympic Games. On both these occasions, the Indian athletes could not win no medals. Indian athletes could win no medals. So Milkha Singh is also a great personality. He is an Indian former track and field sprinter. So what happened to PT Usha? The same incident happened to Milkha Singh also. In 1960, Milkha Singh also lost in the Olympic Games by 1/100th of a second. So that is why it is written that history repeated itself. Okay students, the next rest part we will do in our next class. If you have any question, you can ask me.